I want you to meet Henrietta Lacks, who's had a hand in changing medical biology and genetics for the better, even today. I'm going to share with you a short version of the story of Henrietta Lacks, but the longer version is documented in detail in Rebecca Skloot's 2010 book, The Immortal Life of Henrietta Lacks. In 1951, Henrietta was unknowingly suffering from cervical cancer. After admission and treatment at the only hospital in proximity that would admit black patients, Johns Hopkins Hospital, two samples of Henrietta's cervix tissue were removed, including a cancerous portion, without her permission. Although Henrietta died on October 4, 1951, due to her metastasized cancer, the cells from the tissue biopsy from her cervix continue to be grown in the lab to this day. Known as HeLa cells, HE for Henrietta and LA for Lacks, they were the first human cells that scientists could keep growing in the lab long enough to start actually doing real research. Most human cells would grow for a few days and then die, but HeLa cells kept growing and growing. As a result, the cells were commercialized and distributed all over the world. HeLa cells were used in the development of the Salk vaccine for polio. HeLa cells have also been used for cancer research, AIDS research, gene mapping, and countless other amazing medical advances. And in the spring of 2013, finally the genome sequence of HeLa cells was published for the whole world to see. In return for the outrageous contributions of HeLa cells, despite the fact that they were taken and used without the consent of Henrietta herself, what compensation do you think has been provided to her family over the years since her death? Do you think that there's a multimillion dollar trust fund that's been sent from labs and pharmaceutical companies all over the world that use HeLa cells for discoveries? Or do you think that 0.1% of all profits from biotech companies that use HeLa cells go to the family every year? Or is there $1 million that was paid in a lump sum just once to the family from the NIH? Or is it that $50,000 was paid to each family member from the Johns Hopkins Hospital where the cells were originally isolated? Or do you think that there's been no real financial compensation at all?